Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the world. Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the world. Behold the life-giving cross on which was hung the Savior of the world.
Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him and afflicted.
But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. And the punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed.
We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before his shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth.
By oppression and judgment he was taken away. And who can speak of his descendants? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people, he was stricken.
And they made his grave for the living, and the foolish man his death,
although he had done no violence, and there was no deceit in his mouth.
Holy Lord, holy and mighty God, holy and most merciful Redeemer, God eternal, leave us not to bitter death.
O Lord, have mercy.
Out of gratitude for all that we have been given to us, we will now receive the offering. During the offering time, let us focus on the cross. You may be seated.
Lord, is the Lord.
Was an instrument of Jesus' death, not his life.
To Muslims who regard Jesus highly as a prophet, the cross seems so offensive that they don't believe that God allowed Jesus to die in that way at all. And all of these different groups and religions have their reason to look at the cross with skepticism. And I tell you this not to make a judgment on any of them, but to say that they highlight real aspects of that image. That the cross is a sad and a cruel and sometimes an even offensive symbol. But I think if we deny that point, then we strip the cross of all of its meaning. That 8-year-old boy asked the exact right question, why do we have so many crosses? And the cross is so sad. I had to think about it. But this is what I told him. I said, you're right. The cross is a sad symbol. It's the place where we remember that Jesus died. It's a symbol that reminds us of that dark day in history. So yes, the cross is a symbol of death, but to us, the story of the cross doesn't end there. The story of the cross goes on. It becomes the place where God empties death of all of its power. When we as Christians hear the words of Isaiah that we spoke at the beginning of the service today, we can't help but think of the cross not as an instrument of death, but the way God chose to give life to the world. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows, yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgression, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds, we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. For us, the cross represents second chances. It represents a life free from the power of sin, free from the crushing guilt of the law. The cross represents God's self-giving agape love and is a constant reminder that we too ought to provoke one another to love and good deeds, as we heard from our reading in Hebrews. You see, the scandal of the cross is not that all those outside criticisms are wrong, it's that they are right. And even still, through that very same symbol, we find the love of God poured out on all people. The cross is where we find God's love, God's grace, God's salvation.
Let us hear Jesus' 7 last words from the cross. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
also, who were criminals, were led away to prison, to death with him. When they came to the place that is called the skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing." And they cast lots to divide his clothing.
Today, you shall be with me in paradise.
Thank you.
shall be with me in paradise. A reading from Luke. One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." And he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
God, why have you forsaken me?
after this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, "I am thirsty." A jar full of sour wine was standing there, so they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth.
Thank you.
the wine, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
Thank you.
Into your hands I commend my spirit.
Thank you.